Tommy's answer to these tree huggers out here in California. Tommy is a no-armed Chinese fellow, works for the Street CNC business, and he's out at work. As you know, the CNC business of streets relies on staged events, and he's there to stage an event on Fifth Street. And he tells his assistant, Chief, please roll up sleeve of playing. And she does that for him. He's got his wristwatch there on his ankle. I told you he was a no-armed Chinese fellow. He has to wear his wristwatch on his ankle. And he puts that leg up on a fire hydrant and intently watches that watch as it gets closer to a certain time. Timing is important on the Chinese street. And he tells a worker nearby to fire up that chainsaw, and the worker fires up the chainsaw. And he can't hold his hand up and say go, but he says at that certain time, cut that tree down. And the worker doesn't ask why, he just does it. That's the Chinese reason. He cuts down the palm tree. And it falls across the Fifth Street there, right at the street light. And the worker puts the chainsaw down, still running up on that newsstand, the paper dispenser, paper machine. And of course, all the drivers, it's noontime, and they're out to get their lunch or whatever. And they saw what Tommy and the worker there did, and they're yelling and screaming at him. Why the hell did you do that? Cussing him at one rose down the window and says, why the hell did you do that, you son of a bitch? And a ching. Tommy and the worker there with the chainsaw, they're all having a good time, just laughing at all those drivers stuck, trying to go get their lunch. And when Tommy hears that one call him a son of a bitch, he turns to Ching, and you know what to do. Yeah, Ching has to give the driver the finger for him. And Tommy also tells Ching to have to run down to the other end of the street and tell the other worker with the chainsaw to cut down that palm tree at the other end of the street, the other end of Fifth Street there. And Ching runs down the street to do that. And then Tommy just kind of stands there for a while watching that chainsaw idle. He only makes that chainsaw noise, and he's having wood chipper glass bags. He was brown-nosing and doing whatever they told him like that on the Chinese streets. And he was told to stick his right arm in the wood chipper that was in front of him there. Now Wu, his supervisor, told him to do that. He stuck that right arm in, and the left arm saw the right arm going into the wood chipper, and the left arm jumped off. Well, what would you do, huh? I'm Melton, son of a carpenter Mary. Dad a carpenter, worked on skyscrapers. Mom Marianne. I am the son of a carpenter Mary. I get to make parables. And this is my Tommy. parable series. And of course, it means don't finally do as you're told, otherwise you'll end up missing both your arms. But this, at the end of the day, Tommy is done with the staged events, a big part of the Chinese series. That and a whole lot of folks who look alike. He's done with that that day at staged events. He gets on his unicycle. And he pedals home. He gets there before Rhea, his girlfriend. And man, is she in a mood when she gets in that door. She slams down her stuff there and she says, "You will not believe the day I've had, Tommy." And Tommy kind of meekly says, "What happened?" Andrea says, "I had to run an errand, you know, at lunch, go over to my mom's house and bring her some lunch. Bring her some groceries, and I did that. I was on my way back from that, and this lunatic up ahead, that's what the cops told me, lunatic cut down a palm tree across Fifth Street. And I saw all the traffic backed up, and I decided to turn around and go the other direction. And I did that, and I saw another lunatic had cut down a tree at the other end of Fifth Street there. And it must have took a couple hours for the cops to get the guys with the clearing stuff, the chainsaws and the wood chippers out to clear up the mess so we could go do what we needed to do on our lunch hour, and it turned out to be a 3-hour lunch hour. Who would do something like that, Tommy? Do you know who would do something? And Tommy's kind of looking around, and can't look Rhea in the eye, and says, "I don't know." And she goes into the kitchen, starts slamming things around. She's going to get dinner ready. And Tommy did kind of just sinks into that recliner and watches that Three Stooges marathon he's got on. "I'm melting some cooking here. It's late. I got to cook my dinner. Try to call me 424-229-4140. Make a video of America's High-Tech Lifelines. Where my attention getting parables. My mean stuff, my funny stuff, always am. I tell you to see something for real that affects your family's lifeline. Not one 9/11 flight 93 check in over 8 years of asking. No certified mail either. 4260 Eagle Rock Boulevard, Apartment 409, Los Angeles, California, 90065. John Meltonbury is a full name. Certify your mail, use FedEx, use UPS, make a video of it first, it's going to be stolen. That's that very serious stuff that's also connected to your phone not working when you try to call me and you not knowing when else that phone won't be allowed to work. So make a video, there's the address and there's my phone number. Have your hijack call to me. Post it, be a part of the 4th of July wave of truth. You can do that any day of the year. But make the video, post the video, and come see me in person at Whitwood Travel. Show me the perfect skyline, as you see some skyline imagery there, to build Jesus' immaculate house under, against, under those clouds, against that skyline, however you want to view it. But you got to see me in person. Yeah, try to call me, tell me what I need in that immaculate house to inspire the future and the present of greatness. And see religious senses. If I think it has something to do with those who would be as obvious as to place someone named Hussein in the highest office in America just a few years after 9/11 when we got attacked by a whole lot of Husseins. Try to call me up to tell me what you think about that and see what has gone incredibly wrong in America that we need to fix. We're Americans, we can fix that. We're going to roll up our sleeves. not to check the watts on Tommy's leg, but to fix what I call the Great Wall of China. What they have done to the world is not just keeping me in all of this imagery you see in front of you. It is placing Hussein and Trump in the highest office of America and placing kings and dictators worldwide. Come see me. Be a part of change. My work comes from the professionals of the street, not those who run Tommy. Let's get started building Jesus' house here on earth. At least tell me what that house needs to inspire. Be video pioneers. That's what I think it needs. Make those videos only you can make. Clear them off your phone. Your phone makes a video. Well, there's one right there. With that handsome bald guy there. You had a lunch break. Make a video. Only you can make. Clear it off your phone. Post it, of course, and put it on your flash drive. And pass it along to others. And tell that joke you got perfectly only once. And you never have to tell it again. Come see me. Oh, look for the orange here when you're trying to see the latest. Some talk to Mary. Oh, I don't have the... Got to work on it. We'll get the date and the address on that. Certified mail too. And of course, John Melton Brady. Some talk to Mary can be found in the hearts of true believers. I had trouble printing this, working on this image, though it's not complete today, but... Look for the orange, and that should tell you if, dad forbid, I should lose the number, I'll get another one and have it, but look for the Immaculate Apartment address in a better, when I have, I'm able to use my my equipment on this computer properly. Come see me, have Whitwood Trappers, I'm the perfect place to build, in person. The way true believers have gotten things done for years and years, despite the efforts of what the Crusades were against a while back. Despite the efforts of that, the true believers have gotten things done. Come see me. Show me that perfect place in person.